So I've been working as an engineer for almost 10 years now. And looking back at the time when I was at university, there are a few things that I would have done differently. In this video, I want to share with you three things that I would have done differently if I were able to go back to university, and also why you should consider doing them now while you are at university. Hi everyone. My name is Adriaan, I'm a mechanical engineer, and I make videos covering a wide range of engineering topics. If it's your first time here, welcome. And if you find this video informative or just plain entertaining, do consider giving it a thumbs up. All right, let's get into it. Learning from your mistakes is one of the best ways you can grow as a person, as well as grow in your career. It is always important to take time now and think on what you did in the past, or what you did in a project, and what you did well, and where you can improve, and how you can improve the aspects that you feel were lacking. Now, thinking about my time at university and what I did and didn't do, and how it influenced my engineering career after university, I would like to share three things with you that I would have done differently if I could go back. Number one, don't just do one internship. So my first and only internship was in my first year at university, and it was an unpaid internship at Volkswagen. In my second year of university, I got a bursary from a company, and that sort of guaranteed me a job after I finished my studies. And so I almost got this laid back attitude of, I'm sorted now, I don't need to worry about internships any longer, I've got a job waiting for me at the end of my studies. But then that is not the only thing an internship is for: getting a possible job at the end of your studies. There are so much more that you can learn from an internship. You can learn people skills, teamworking skills. You can get exposed to the industry where your internship is. So for instance, automotive engineering, a manufacturing plant. So you can get a lot of technical skills and see how the theory that is being taught at university is applied at industry level. You can also put your internship on your CV, and that will make you stand out above the rest of the applicants who most probably didn't do an internship. Now imagine if you actually took an internship in your first year of university, and then you took a few more in the later years of your university career, and you are able to show the growth that you've experienced through these internships. That will ensure that you stand out head and shoulders above the rest of the applicants. Another thing that is beneficial when you actually go for an internship is that you are growing your network. Now, as a student at university, my network was non-existent at the time. And when I finished university, it was still non-existent. Now imagine leaving university with a sizable network that you can use in the future to help you out or assist you with anything that you might need. Number two, be curious and inquisitive when you are at your internship. So going back to the example when I was at my first and only internship, that internship was unpaid because I really wanted to go and intern at Volkswagen. They said it's possible, but they cannot pay me. So what ended up happening is that I would sit at my desk and I would wait for work to come to me. Now, because it was unpaid, I assumed people did not really bother with going out of their way to give me work, because if I was paid, then they would say, all right, we are paying him to be here, he might as well work. So for me, it was a situation where I was sitting there waiting to get work, and I didn't get that much, which ended up me twiddling my thumbs and not getting the most out of the experience. Now, if I could go back, I would go and I would identify someone that was doing something really interesting or something that I was interested in, and I would shadow them. I would literally be their shadow and follow them everywhere they go. I would ask if I can help them out, if I can. I would ask questions if I don't understand anything, and I would basically soak up everything that he tells me. And this is not only relevant for when you go to internship. This is also applicable for when you are starting a graduate role after university, or even if you're just starting a new position at a new company. The best way to get into your role is to follow someone that's got more experience than you, to ask questions, to go to meetings, to be seen, and to better understand the whole ecosystem of the company so that you can become intricately familiar with it. And it doesn't even need to apply to shadowing an engineer. So for instance, if you are in a design engineer position and you are part of the design team, it might be good to also go and look at what happens after you've submitted the design. Who actually goes and manufactures it? Who actually goes and quality checks it? If you are able to go and shadow them, you would become more familiar with the process after your role ends. And the people in the manufacturing department and the people in the quality department will get to know you as well. And you would build that relationship. So when in the future you need something to be done quickly, or you're sort of stuck between a rock and a hard place, you can count on them to help you, because you've built up this trust by being visible, by being helpful, by wanting to learn. One thing that I always appreciate from junior engineers, if they are showing their enthusiasm to learn and wanting to absorb knowledge, that will make me much more eager to teach them, knowing that the effort that I do to impart knowledge will be well received and will be applied wherever needed. Now, the benefits of being inquisitive and curious during your internship or your graduate role or when starting a new role at a new company is that you become familiar with the processes of the company quite quickly. You get to know people fairly quickly and you start to build relationships that you can count on in the future when you need help. Number three, join an engineering student society. When I was at university, there were a lot of societies that I could join, and I joined the Engineering Student Council. The Engineering Student Council was sort of the umbrella council that looked after the well-being of engineering students. So they would be responsible for the class representatives, any complaints that come in, they would take that to the lecturers, and they would organize all the socials for the engineering students. So while there, I learned a lot of people skills as well as teamworking skills, which were great. And I used that in my engineering career after university, but also try and join a society that focused more on the technical aspects of engineering. So this could be societies such as Formula Student, the SAE Badger Student Society, and even the Shell Eco-Marathon Society. Try and get a list of all the student societies that are at your university and see which one speaks to you the most and join it. The benefits of joining an engineering student society is at the least you are seeing your design being built and used in real life. There is nothing as satisfying as designing something, building it, and letting it loose in the real world and see how it prosper, and even improving it in an iterative way. The best situation would be if you join an engineering society the first year, you go through the whole design process of, for instance, SAE Badger car. And then in your second and your third year, you iteratively improve your designs that you are responsible for. And then at the end, when you start applying for roles, you can show this growth that you've experienced in applying the design process and how you got better at doing it. So not only is it beneficial to put it on your CV, because that's in a sense showing some work experience, it's also fun. And it's a social event to connect with your peers and again, grow your network. At the university that I studied, they actually had an SAE Badger Society. And only later, I heard that one of my friends were part of the society. And the things that they were building sounded absolutely amazing. To design your own CVT gearbox or be responsible for the cage of the car, designing it, optimizing it, and then actually building it sounded like so much fun. And I really felt that I have missed a lot. Ultimately, these suggestions will add value to your engineering experience. It will help you add valuable engineering knowledge to your engineering career, which will be beneficial when you start applying for roles after university. It will also help you appreciate what a mechanical engineer does and what you can look forward to in your mechanical engineering career. If you have any other recommendations that you want to add to my three suggestions, do put them in the comments below. I would love to hear your thoughts. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Bye.